Hi there. Not too long ago, I made a joystick for Unity Bolt and I made it available for you guys to download. Now I went back to it and made some improvements. So this is how it looks right now. I also added a button to it and fixed some bugs. So in this video, I'm gonna walk you through how you can set it up in your own Bolt project. There's a link in description where you can download it. And once you download it, it should be a Unity package. So go ahead and drop it into your assets folder. And right here, I have all the files that are in that package. Click import. Once you import, you should get a folder, SP Joysticks. Let's go inside there. There are two prefabs, joystick button and joystick. Just go ahead and drop them into your canvas if you already have it created. And let's go ahead also drop the joystick button as well. So that's the default position for them. One thing about my canvas setting, I have it set to scale with screen size and I use the reference resolution 800 by 600. And for screen match mode, I like to use the match height. So that's just a quick setup that I use. If we go to joystick, the options are still the same as in previous version. So max radius, and for the max radius, in this version, I also scale it up and down based on that canvas scale, because I noticed when you resize the screens, the range actually changed in the previous version. So that's one of the fixes that I did. If you're using the previous version of the joystick and you just imported the new one, there might be an overwrite you have to do to get it to update. So right here, you can see that I have overwrite options and I can click on this knob flow machine and click revert. So that's one thing you might need to do when you update to the new version. For the joystick button, there's no bolt elements here. It's just plain Unity image, text, and a button. Now let's go ahead and look how we can actually use it in our game. So in my player, if I go to flow graph, I have the game logic set up here. To get the values from the joysticks, there is two options. So there is just joystick and also joystick smooth. At any point, you can go inside and see what's going on in any of these nodes. And for the joystick smooth, I just have a lerp node that smooths out the movement of the joystick. And in this version, there's a small update that I did. I'm using the get variable instead of getting the variable from the set variable, because it's causing some issues when you were using more than one of these units in your graph. So I'm going to set up my game with a joystick smooth. Connect it to the fixed flow update and connect it to this unit, which just continues running the logic of my game. And my game is controlled by horizontal movement of the joystick. So I'll just use the horizontal. Also, I need to pass in the game object of the joystick. So let's find our joystick, drag and drop it in here. And that's the setup for the joystick. Now for the joystick button, there's another macro. So let's add that one in. And we can pass in the joystick button right here. Click and drag it in here. And the connections that I have here are some events. So unbutton down, unbutton up, unbutton click, and also a Boolean value. If it's down, then it's gonna return true. If it's up, it's gonna return false. Again, you can go inside here and see how it's set up. It's pretty simple. I just use a toggle flow to save the is on or off state. In my player, I already have the logic for firing a rocket when I hit space on the keyboard. And now I can use one of these updates to trigger the fire logic like that. And that is all that you had to do. So there you go. You can see that the controls are working. I'm using Unity Remote to control the inputs. You can see that my mouse is not moving and I'm controlling the character. So in this version, I got the multi-touch to be supported as well. That's why you can move the joystick and fire at the same time. And you can also have multiple joysticks. So if you need another joystick, you can just drag it and drop it into your canvas. Go into the inspector, position it where you want it. And now you can click play and you should be able to control both of the joysticks independent at the same time. You weren't able to do that with the previous version, but in this version, you can do that. In your player flow graph, if you want to add another joystick control to something like controlling a camera, you can follow the same process, use smooth, and then you just connect the other joystick to here and connect it to wherever the logic of this joystick needs to go. So there you go. I hope you guys find these controls really useful. They're really easy to set up and pretty simple to use as well. click on the like button, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. But now, let's set some high score to this game.